Welcome to the Efficient eLearning SAP Training Series. In this video, we'll be converting a purchase requisition into a purchase order using transaction ME21N. And here's the content we'll be covering. We'll start by confirming where transaction code ME21N fits in the procure-to-pay process. Before converting the purchase requisition into a purchase order, we'll review the status of the purchase requisition using transaction ME53N, Display Purchase Requisition, and transaction ME5A, Purchase Requisition List Display. We'll then convert a purchase requisition into a purchase order in SAP using transaction ME21N. And finally, once the purchase requisition is converted into a purchase order, we'll again review the status of the purchase requisition using transaction ME53N, Display Purchase Requisition, and transaction ME5A, Purchase Requisition List Display. We'll then divert our attention to the purchase order using transaction ME23N, Display Purchase Order, and transaction ME2N, Purchase Orders by PO Number. Let's begin with where transaction ME21N fits in the procure-to-pay process. Transaction ME21N is used to create a purchase order, or, as is the case here, convert an approved purchase requisition into a purchase order. For the sake of simplicity in this video, we'll be converting the purchase requisition into a purchase order using transaction ME21N, Create Purchase Order. But note that there are other ways to facilitate this step, most notably using transaction ME59N, Automatic Generation of Purchase Orders. Time permitting, we'll create a separate video for transaction ME59N. For the moment, we'll focus on the simplest scenario, that is, using transaction ME21N. Okay, so we've established where transaction ME21N fits in the procure-to-pay process. Now let's review the status of the purchase requisition in SAP prior to converting it into a purchase order using transaction ME21N. Navigate to the SAP menu folder Logistics, Materials Management, Purchasing, and Purchase Requisition. Double-click on the entry for transaction ME53N, Display Purchase Requisition. In my screen, the correct purchase requisition is currently displayed. However, if the correct purchase requisition is not currently displayed, click on the Other Purchase Requisition button. Click in the Purchase Requisition field, type in the relevant purchase requisition number, and then click the Other Document button. Let's now click on the relevant tabs and confirm the status of the purchase requisition. If required, click the Expand Header button to expand the header section. Then click on the Release Strategy tab. The release indicator is set to RFQ/Purchase Order. This means the purchase requisition can be converted to a purchase order. Click on the Status tab at Item Details level. Note the processing status is set to N, not edited. This means the purchase requisition has not yet been converted to a purchase order. Click the green back arrow to return to the SAP main menu. Expand the List Displays folder and double-click on transaction ME5A. Click in the Purchase Requisition field and type in the relevant purchase requisition number. Clear out any other fields that have automatically populated so that we are left with Scope of List ALV to utilize the more efficient ALV grid reporting style, Sort Indicator 1, sorting by purchase requisition number and item, and the following checkboxes: Click the Execute button to run the report. Click in the gap to the right of the horizontal scroll bar to scroll across the report one page at a time. You'll notice the Release Indicator field is set to 2 RFQ/Purchase Order, and the Processing Status is set to N, not edited. Click the green back arrow twice to return to the SAP main menu. We'll now convert the purchase requisition to a purchase order using transaction ME21N. Expand the Purchase Order folder and then the Create folder and double-click on transaction ME21N. If it's the first time you've used this transaction, you'll see this help pane on the left. For the purpose of this demonstration, and to maximize the viewable columns for the purchase order, I'll close this pane by clicking the Close button. If at any stage you wish to review this help section, you can open the help pane by clicking this icon. As we are converting a purchase requisition into a purchase order, we need to utilize the document overview. Again, if you're using this transaction for the first time, the document overview section may be hidden. If the document overview is not currently visible, you can click on the Document Overview On button to display the document overview. Click the Selection Variant drop-down and choose Purchase Requisitions. Click in the Purchase Requisition Number field and type in the relevant purchase requisition number. Ensure the remaining fields are blank and then click the Execute button. The first field we need to populate is the Order Type field. The order type allows a distinction to be made between different kinds of purchase order. In this example, we'll be creating a standard purchase order. Click the drop-down list for the order type field and choose Standard PO. Now click on the purchase requisition, drag it into the shopping basket, and release the mouse button. Note the warning message regarding the delivery date at the bottom of the screen. If required, click the Expand Items button to expand the Item Overview section. Click in the Delivery Date field and then click the drop-down list to the right. In this example, the delivery is expected on the first workday a week from now. Click on the relevant date to select it. Click the Enter button to validate the purchase order details. Note the warning message at the bottom of the screen regarding the price being adopted from the purchase requisition. Press the Enter key on the keyboard to bypass the warning message. Let's now make a note of the field values that have been copied from the purchase requisition. If the header section is collapsed, click the Expand Header button. Now click on the Org Data tab. The purchasing organization and the purchasing group are copied from the purchase requisition. The company code is derived from the plant that was copied from the purchase requisition at item level. At item details level, the account assignment category, short text, order quantity, net price, material group, plant, and storage location are all copied from the purchase requisition. If we click on the Account Assignment tab at Item Details level, we can see the details, namely the GL Account and Cost Center, that were copied from the requisition. The purchase order now contains all the required information. Click the check button to confirm there are no error messages or warning messages that need to be addressed. Note the message at the bottom of the screen confirming there are no errors or warnings. Now click the Save button to create the purchase order. Note the message at the bottom of the screen with the purchase order number. Now click the green back arrow to return to the SAP main menu. Now that we've created the purchase order, let's display the purchase requisition and run the purchase requisition list display to see the impact of creating the purchase order. In the SAP menu, collapse the purchase order folder. Now double-click on transaction ME53N, display purchase requisition. Again, if the correct purchase requisition is not currently displayed, click on the Other Purchase Requisition button. Click in the Purchase Requisition field, type in the relevant purchase requisition number, and then click the Other Document button. Now click on the Status tab at Item Details level. As a result of the creation of the purchase order, the Processing Status field has been updated to PO Created. Additionally, the purchase order number is now displayed. Click the green back arrow to return to the SAP main menu. Now double-click on transaction ME5A, Purchase Requisition List Display. Click in the Purchase Requisition field and type in the relevant purchase requisition number. Select the Closed Requisitions checkbox. Then clear out any other fields that have automatically populated, so that we are left with Scope of List ALV, to utilize the more efficient ALV grid reporting style, Sort Indicator 1, sorting by purchase requisition number and item, and the following checkboxes. Now click the Execute button to run the report. Click in the gap to the right of the horizontal scroll bar to scroll across the report one page at a time. You'll notice the processing status has changed to B, PO Created. Additionally, the purchase order item, and purchase order date fields are now populated. Click the green back arrow twice to return to the SAP main menu. We'll now turn our attention to displaying the purchase order and running the relevant purchase order report. In the SAP main menu, expand the purchase order folder. Now double-click on transaction ME23N, display purchase order. Click the selection variant drop-down and choose My Purchase Orders. In my screen, the relevant purchase order is already displayed. However, if in your screen the relevant purchase order isn't displayed, find it in the list on the left and then double-click on the entry. If the item overview section isn't currently visible, click the Expand Items button to expand the item overview section. Note the reference to the purchase requisition and the purchase requisition item. Now click the green back arrow to return to the SAP main menu. Expand the List Displays folder and double-click on transaction ME21N. Click in the Purchasing Document field and type in the relevant purchase order number. Clear out any other fields that have automatically populated except for the Scope of List field. This field value should be set to best_ALV to utilize the more efficient ALV grid reporting style. Please note, the code for the ALV layout for purchase orders in your system may be different. Now click the Execute button to run the report. As we progress through the steps in the Procure-to-Pay process, our main focus in this report will be these last four columns. Still to be delivered quantity, and still to be delivered value. The values in these columns currently represent the full order quantity and order value, as we have not yet received any goods and not posted any goods receipts in SAP. Likewise, the still to be invoiced quantity and still to be invoiced value currently represent the full order quantity and order value, as we've not yet been sent any invoices from the vendor and not yet posted any invoices in SAP. That's all we have for this video. Remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to be notified when new videos are uploaded. Thanks for watching.